Hello, my name is Hamid Basiri. I'm one of the infectious disease specialists here at the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia, and I also have a background in immunology. We know that while children generally do well with COVID-19, that they are just as susceptible as adults. Even healthy children without any underlying comorbidities or other medical conditions can still contract disease. Sometimes that disease can be severe. Clinically, I can tell you that I've seen a variety of different sequelae of actually getting disease. Certainly, there's the acute complications of COVID-19, where children can come in and have respiratory distress, need help with oxygenation and breathing. And I've seen kids do well with that. I've seen kids, unfortunately, need things like a nasal cannula to help them with a little bit of oxygen. And occasionally, some kids who land in our intensive care unit who really suffer from the more severe disease. In addition to the acute presentation of COVID-19 and the respiratory distress that you see, there's also a variety of post-acute sequelae of SARS-CoV-2. So one of the other things we see clinically, and this happens in children regardless of whether they actually come into the hospital and need to stay in the hospital, or even in children who develop some very, very mild symptoms, is this concept of the long haul syndrome or the post-acute sequelae of SARS-CoV-2 in children, or PASC. PASC takes a number of different forms, and in different children it can manifest itself very differently. And again, the spectrum can encompass some mildly annoying stuff, which, you know, kids can do well with and eventually resolve, but it can also involve some pretty debilitating type of phenomenon that can really affect the lives of our children. So that could include anything from not being able to sleep, not being able to breathe as well as they used to previously, any exertion, any running around, making them incredibly fatigued, not just because they're tired, but much, much more fatigued than they would have been at any other time. The inability to concentrate and focus, which really affects their learning in schools and after school. The occasional joint pains that come and go, abdominal pains that come and go, that again, interfere with the actual ability of our children to do what they're supposed to be doing. Playing, learning, and really developing as time goes on. And then one of the more severe post-acute sequelae of SARS-CoV-2 is a syndrome that myself and a group of us collaboratively have been studying. This syndrome is called the Multisystem Inflammatory Syndrome in Children, or MIS-C. And what MIS-C is a hyperactivation of the immune system. So children can get acute COVID-19. In many instances, the acute COVID-19 that they get is actually asymptomatic, so they're not coughing, they're not having breathing difficulties or anything else, and they actually resolve that portion of their disease fairly nicely. And then several weeks later, sometime generally between 4 and 7 weeks later, they develop a hyperinflammatory syndrome. So what does that mean? Well, they develop pretty high spiking fever that can last for a few days. And in addition to that, some of the children develop rashes, redness to their eyes, and can start to have more fatigue, malaise, weakness, and the virus, or the sequelae of the virus, can actually affect their heart function, which can be not just severe, but potentially life-threatening. So we've seen a number of those children here at the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia, and we formed a group to try and actually study what is happening with their immune system. Why is it becoming hyperactivated? We and others around the world have started to really just scratch the surface of that. I don't know that any one of us has an answer as of yet. So I think there are many really good reasons to consider vaccination of children, both for preventing disease in them, in the acute sense, in the post-acute sense, and with respect to decreasing the transmission and the number of susceptible hosts that the virus actually has in the community.